I'm super happy to hear this, but I'm not so happy to let you know that we are now approaching our final seed team that will be here with us on stage. If you remember, I told you at the beginning that we didn't really choose any particular order of appearance here on stage for our teams, but I have also admitted to you that we did a little choosing when we chose the team to start with, Unico. And we were also perhaps a little bit influenced when we were choosing the team to conclude with. So we picked them purposefully as well. And the reason for that is simple, because the project that they are developing is all about what happens when the final curtain falls. It looks beyond this lifetime, after death, seeking to secure our legacy for those that we leave behind. They have developed blockchain-based time capsules that could contain all of your digital possessions, like photographs or, say, cryptocurrencies. And when the time comes, this digital heritage could be safely passed on to those that you've left behind. If all this is starting to make you sentimental, you're ready to hear from the team itself. Please welcome with me our final seed project team members, coming from Toulouse, France, but originally also from Chile, Felipe and Colleen from Legacy. Bonsoir, buenas noches. When we spoke before the show, you told us a really touching story about how you came up with the idea for Legacy. Would you care sharing that with the audience?
Yeah, no problem. So actually, the initial idea for Legacy came to me not long after September 18th, 2003. And that's the night my father passed away, actually. And he died when he was quite young, relatively speaking. And well, because of this, we never really got the chance to say goodbye. We never got the chance to speak about life and ourselves in a more mature manner. And especially, he never got the chance to prepare for our family for this moment. It was just something that happened. So at Legacy, we've realized that this isn't a unique problem. This is very common nowadays. People don't do this. They don't plan for this moment. It's a very complex task, and it takes a lot of time. We have so many things to do in life, so many things to see in the world, and so much work to do that people don't plan for this. Although we consider that it's a very important thing to do, and not only that, but it's the only thing in life we know for certain. I mean, we're all going to die someday. So we're trying to build a solution, a very simple solution, to solve this specific problem.
What is that solution?
So in short, we are building a smart wheel solution designed for the digital society. With Legacy, you will be able to transfer your digital assets in a really secure way. It includes your crypto. And our technology includes a proof of life and proof of death engine that will allow us to determine if our user has died or is still alive. And we also want to create a platform that, thanks to the community, will self-involve and be really long-lasting.
What is a proof of life engine? Can you help us understand this concept?
Sure. Our proof of life and proof of death engine basically can know if a person or a user has online and offline activity, and therefore conclude and determine if a person is alive or not. It's a five-layered system in which each consecutive layer is more reliable than the previous. And it's an engine that's been designed and optimized specifically for this task alone.
And you were talking about a capsule where you could store all the digital possession. What's that?
Yeah, you can think of a capsule as a container in which a legacy will store data on. It's, as a user, we can create as many capsules as we want, and we can assign one or many users or contacts to each of these containers. So they could be configured so that when the conditions are met, these containers will be sent autonomously to our contacts.
So I could store any object within the capsule? Like, I remember, you know, we even spoke to Unico about collectibles. I asked them, could I turn my physical items into digital collectibles? Is there a similar option here? Could I store my physical items in this time capsule?
Yeah, you can basically store everything, your memories, such as photos, videos, and letters that you left for your family, and also your cryptocurrency key. And you can also, in the second version of Legacy, you will be able to transfer your belongings and objects that you cherish, thanks to the smart property, like your house or your car, for example.
Okay, they already start to sound like a will, like a testimony. Are you Are you planning to also evolving your project further later on? I remember you were explaining to me about smart wills. What is that?
So yeah, basically, in fact, one of the things we want to do is make lawyers and notaries, which are basically the current manners of how we do this today, make them part of our system. We're not competing against them. We want to make them part of this system and want the platform to work with it, with them, and make the platform work for them, actually. So yeah, we are actually building smart wills, and it's going to be a testament that's going to be legally compliant in the future.
So that's interesting. For example, I could make an oral will and have it taped and then store it in a capsule together with all my possessions, so everything could be just accessible in one place. My final will and all my possessions, I could do all that.
And in fact, one of the main advantages is that we can modify this whenever we want. We can edit it as quickly as we want with three clicks on internet without having to go to the notary in person and all that.
So hopefully, if I can really have the total control of what I put in there and what I leave behind, I could prevent some big family disputes among my family members once I'm gone. That definitely sounds great. But let's try and make this a little lighter as well. I mean, death, after all, never makes us feel comfortable and easy, although it is a very sentimental and a project of great value that I find I'm very keen about it myself. But I'm wondering, could that be also used in this lifetime? For example, you know, when I was thinking about your startup, I was thinking about the option of, you know, so many people nowadays, instead of having their friends bringing material gifts to their child on their first birthday, you know, would ask them to rather tape a video clip and make a statement for this one-year-old child of their friends that a child will be able to open and see and hear when he or she reaches 18, for example. I can see that this, you know, capsule of yours could be used for something like this. I could store, you know, like thoughts and statements from my friends to my children and have them open, even if I'm gone, or it would just automatically open at 18th birthday. So you could use that in this lifetime, for this lifetime's purposes.
Yeah. I think we are building a really easy and simple tool for everybody. So we are not targeting only elderly people. We are just we think nowadays it's a problem that we prepare our testament only when we are old or ill, and we think death is unpredictable, so it could sadly happen tomorrow, and we should all prepare our testament as soon as possible for our family. And it also could be used for a birthday, like you said. We could set the capsule for the birthday.
I'm looking forward to using a time capsule in this lifetime already. But I'm thinking, you know, probably by the time our moment comes, when we get old, we will be able to use this. We're quite digitally versed. But how, you know, is this product available for, I mean, is it, will every generation be able to use it? How will those that perhaps don't have digital access of any kind, that they don't have any digital knowledge, how will they be able to use it?
Well, the tool is supposed to be very easy to use. It's going to be easy to use and simple. But
I can't get my mom to learn how to text on Viber, so.
Yeah, well, like as Colleen said, like our main target customers in this moment, and users basically, are younger people, 30-year-olds, because we're already versed with crypto and technology, and we can set that up for our mothers and our grandmothers and grandfathers. Mm-hmm. So I think it can be achieved.
Yeah. So out of all these possibilities, what will your first steps after today's crowd sale be? What will you do first? What will you focus on?
That's actually quite clear for us right now. We want to boost our communication strategy so we can build like a very engaged community, because one aspect of what we haven't spoke about is our community and how that's going to help us evolve the platform in the future. And so we need to boost our communications, but we're really going to concentrate basically on the technology and the product and the service itself. We want to have a much more robust prototype before the main crowd sale.
So once again, why have you chosen to sell your product, get funds for your product through crowd sale?
Yeah, again, as I just mentioned, like the community really is important in terms of how we pretend for this product and platform to evolve in the future. We want it to be self-amending, and we want the community itself to participate in how the platform adapts to local cultures and to future technologies, for example. We don't know if email will exist in 50 more years. So we need an engaged community, and this community can be rewarded through our token model, for example.
And you found co-founded to be a good partner in that?
Yeah, at the moment, yes, very much.
We're very happy to have you here with us tonight as well. Maybe for the end, so that, you know, we have started your presentation and kept it on a sentimental level, but maybe you can give us some anecdote, a funny story. I'm surprising you with this question.
Yeah, why not? I mean, there's one thing. We have this phrase. It's actually not written by us. It's written by one of our advisors, Julien, which is with us here tonight. And it's legacy is the future of your past.
Right. What does
and
that mean?
We love this phrase because it's actually... it's really positive, and that's the way we like to look at legacy, actually. For us, legacy isn't about death, and we have to really make this clear. It's about life. It's about celebrating life, how the Mexicans do it, and the Irish do it with El Día de la Muerte and all those celebrations. We want to celebrate life, and we want to be able to send what we've lived in life to our future generations.
So I hope all of you get your time capsules as soon as possible, as soon as it's developed fully. Thank you very much, Felipe and Colleen.
Thank you
were the last one to close the showcase for us. It was a great pleasure having you here on stage.
Thank you.
Give them a big round of applause. Thank you.